Good day and welcome to our class on Directional Movement Index, DMI. And this is a direct follow-up video to our ADX presentation on Average Directional Index. ADI and DMI are part of Wells Wilder's Directional Movement System. So the Directional Movement Index assists in determining if security is trending and attempts to measure the strength of that trend. Good piece of information if you have it. The DMI is a technical indicator that is typically shown at the bottom or above the price chart. It is calculated by comparing the current price with the previous price range. DMI then displays the results as an upward positive directional indicator and a downward negative directional indicator. Now, Wells Wilder's directional movement system is not based on your standard moving averages formula, like most indicators are today. This indicator's default settings are used as a 14-day smoothing, but it's very different from the 14-day or 14-period exponential moving average. The standard EMA converts the time period into fractions. A formula is used for the conversion, however, the directional movement system does not use the same formula. Now, we have explained that formula below for the DMI. EMAs, which are really quite different, actually add more weight to the most current time system by coming up with it's an add-on that you give to each segment, each last time segment, where DMI is only looking at the highs and the lows. The DMI also calculates the strength of the upward or downward movement and displays the results as a strength line called the ADX, which I had mentioned to you previously. So on here, we see the ADX line as the yellow and the DM lines as the red and the green. DMI lines are usually given in reds and greens, okay, just for understanding's sake, for no other reason. And your ADX line is then most often given to you actually in a blue, any color that that's not the same as the red and the green lines. So as you can see on here, we have the ADX line, minus DI line and the plus D line. Green and red, and in this case, the ADX line is yellow. So while the DI and the minus DI and the DI plus shows direction, investors use ADX to analyze the strength of the uptrend and the downtrend. An ADX with a recording above 25 means that there's strong trends in place. Whereas if it falls below 20, shows us the price is likely to be moving sideways. Now, ADX gives you direction, not in bearish and bullish. It's only a measure of the strength of the trend, whether it's not looking at whether the trend's going up or down. It's whatever the current trend is, what is the strength of that trend? So the plus DI line is the difference between the highest price of the current day or the current time period and the highest price of the previous time period. The DI or the minus DI does the same calculation with the current and previous lows. So you're not comparing opens and closes. You're only looking at the highest point it hit and the lowest point it hit in this time frame to the previous time frame. Now, we can also use this with a 14-period average that averages out the DM plus DM minus DM to give us a more smoothed out look at the period. So using the DI, the plus DI, and the minus DI, when the plus DI line is higher than the minus DI line, these are the two lines below on your chart, then the market is said to be trending upward. The trader can then take a long ride. Similarly, if the DI, the minus DI line is higher than the DI plus line, then the market is said to be trending down, not the ADX. Remember, ADX, as I told you, only tells you the momentum of the, or the strength of the trend, not the direction. It's the DI lines that you have to use then combined with the ADX to see directional and which way you should be going. So in this case, we can see that the DI line crossed here and moved above the D plus line, and here we saw the opposite. So here we see the initiation of a downtrend. Here we see the initiation of an uptrend. Now, its formula is quite different than you say, oh, I got a crossover strategy. It's just like at MACD. But it's not, because it's using different formulas to make these lines. The DMI can be used to confirm the trend of the price signal. The trend is stronger if the spread between the DI, the plus and the minus, are larger. So the bigger the difference here, the stronger this trend is here. So if the plus DI is far above the minus DI, it indicates a strong upward trend. If the minus DI is far above the plus DI, it's the opposite. It strongly denotes a downwards movement, a downtrend. So when we combine this with ADX, which is all part of Wells Wilder's directional movement system, when the ADX line is over 25, then the market is said to be trending and ranging if it's under 25. The ADX reading above 25 signifies a strong trend, where if it's below 25, it's a weak trend. So we can combine this ADX line with the DI plus and the DI minus. Okay, traders can also collectively use DI plus, DI minus, and ADX as well for individual trading purposes. Some traders may only analyze ADX for analyzing the strength of a trend, whereas some traders may analyze only the direction trend of the movements, or you can combine them together. Now, there are some limitations. Directional movement index produces a lot of false signals. Thus, one should be careful when using the indicator. And remember, because the indicator is also not suggesting price, stop losses, risk reward, it can be suggesting a strong upward trend, but it's not telling you how long that trend is going to go for, how far it's going to progress. So in general, when the DI line is above the DI minus line, the market is moving in an uptrend, and the opposite. Remember, everything mirrors everything else. Therefore, when trading a trend strategy, favor long positions when the DI plus is above the DI minus. Other traders prefer scout out trades that depend on choppy price action. When trading is rainbound and choppy, that means that ADX is likely below 20. Now, if the ADX was likely below 20 and the DI and plus and minus were fairly close together, what would happen, or what would you think would happen, if the ADX started climbing above 25 and the line started crossed over and started to widen? You have the beginnings of a strong trend. Now, there's some interesting facts about the directional movement index. DMI enables to separate strong and weak trends and open trades when the price momentum is clearly defined. The negative DI shows the pressure coming from the market sellers. Positive DI shows the price pressures coming from market buyers. Now remember, negative DI is coming from the lows. The positive DI is coming from the highs achieved, not from the opens and closes. Traders may want to use DMI in combination with other indicators to avoid possible false trading signals. Using DMI in combination with Fibonacci retracement or candlestick patterns may filter out false signals. DMI assists traders identifying direction in which the price could move in the future. DMI can be used for different assets and on different time frames. DMI is easy to put on your charts. You just click on the DI indicator, it drops it on your charts. You adjust it to the time frame you're using, and it will quickly adjust to short-term time frames and is very accurate. But remember, it's a lot more accurate when the market is trending or a trend is about to begin. DMI can be used for different assets on different time frames. The most important signal generated with the DMI are the crossovers between the DI plus and the DI minus. DMI default values can be adjusted by the trader based on their trading style. So the bottom line is, with other technical indicators, the directional movement index should also be used with other technical tools such as volume, price action, candlestick patterns to confirm a signal given by this indicator. And that's all today, folks, on DMI. Add it with ADX onto your charts and start watching it closely to see how accurate it is, and maybe you'll factor it into your future trading. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Please subscribe to my channel and watch our other videos. Bye now.